Good morning, everybody. Welcome to our morning meditation. We will be practicing some vagal breathing to help us tune in, calm down, feel really smooth for our day. And then a special meditation called Meditation for Projection and Protection from the Heart. And it's something that we do in Kundalini yoga classes to protect our space, protect ourselves, and it involves extending the arms straight out on a 45 degree angle, so it's a little bit higher than the heart. And the idea is we're going to send a mantra and we're going to create these waves or beams of light in all directions. So you can imagine like the petals of a flower all the way around you. We'll be imagining that. And it's this protection that goes out into our electromagnetic field. If you're doing it for a short period of time, you would just envision in front, the side, the back, and the other side. So you have like your four corners protected. But we'll do it for a few minutes, and you can actually do in between four corners as well, which is really neat. So it amplifies, strengthens your electromagnetic field, and strengthens your energy, and it's like your protective bubble around you. So that's really great in these times, and all times. And I'm also testing out a new mic today. It just arrived yesterday, so thank you, Dan, for the mic. So maybe if you guys want to comment, if you can hear my voice a little bit better, if it's working for you. So very happy to have that. And let's begin with vagal breathing. So pick a posture, a mudra for your hands. It might be Guya mudra, might be the mudra of equanimity. You might have your hands over your heart, over your lungs, or those worry spots on the side. That's a spleen heart meridian connection. And if you hold those, it erases worry out of your neck, your shoulders, and your jaw, which is really great. Melt your stress away. So pick whichever mudra feels great for you today. And we're going to close our eyes. Just close your eyes. Let everything relax. So we're letting our mind relax. We're letting our shoulders drop down. Just letting your skull relax, your eyes, your cheekbones, your jaw. Let there be space between your upper and lower teeth. Let your tongue relax, especially the place where your tongue attaches into your throat. Let that place soften. Let the softening continue down into your heart. And as your heart is softening, let all of your muscles soften. Back muscles, your leg muscles, your belly muscles. We're gently breathing into the belly, letting the belly expand. We're inhaling through the nose and exhaling out through the mouth. And as we inhale through the nose, we're drawing the breath into the back of the sinuses, into the back of the throat. And this is creating a sound, something like an ocean wave. And then when we exhale, we're exhaling out through the mouth with another wave. It's ha, H-A, like we're misting our glasses before we clean them. Inhaling, ocean wave. Exhaling, ha. As we're exhaling, we're allowing the exhale to become longer and longer. The longer the exhale becomes, the more we dip down into the vagal system. The vagal system is our rest and repair and relax mode. Being more vagal helps our blood pressure to be normal, our endocrine system to work really well, and our immune system to work really well. And our mind to work really well. That's a good thing. So For every exhale, just letting it become longer and longer. Remembering that when we exhale out through the mouth, we automatically release tension. And as your exhale becomes longer and longer, let yourself coast at the bottom of your exhale for a little bit before you take your next inhale. As this coasting, that takes us even deeper into the vagal system. And it's when we're vagal that our body does its repair and healing. It's very important for us to spend time in our vagal state. As you're ready, gently return to natural breathing. Minutes or so where we're just naturally breathing is a very important part of the practice. It's a time to notice whether your breath stays fairly similar to the vagal breathing, like slow and deep in the belly, or it might return to something that's a little bit faster or a little bit higher. And that kind of lets you know where you are in your vagal state, if you're truly like sitting deep in your vagal state, or we're practicing getting to the vagal state, and maybe we drop down a few notches, but as soon as we finish the practice, we're going back up a little bit sympathetic. I think it's a very interesting thing to observe in that minute of just natural breathing, where your system is at. And taking that minute also helps your body to reset its set point. So you're lowering your set point deeper into the vagal system. Now gently open your eyes, and we're going to move into our practice, the meditation for projection, so we're projecting our energy out, and protection from the heart. So this is done with love and compassion and kindness, and it's the energy of the heart. There's something really neat about the heart field. So everything in our body, and everything in the world, and everything in the universe, has electromagnetic fields, and each of our organs vibrates with its own electromagnetic field. And when we're in harmony with ourselves, all of our organs and systems and cells and everything are entrained. It's called entrainment. They're all working together in harmony, and that's a very healthy system and a very healthy mind. But sometimes we have emotional things or psychological things or physical things that throw that harmony off. So the heart might not be doing so well, or the brain or the liver or the kidneys, and our body goes into disharmony or dis-ease, and then we have physical symptoms. And so the idea with things like sound baths and singing and humming and mantra and breathing and working with our electromagnetic field with musical instruments, the sound of water, the sound of birds, all these different sounds help us to come back into that entrainment, into that harmony. And when we're in that harmony, we are projecting out with our electromagnetic field a strong, beautiful message. And so the neat thing about the heart, when scientists measure the heart electromagnetic field, it can be anywhere from 8 to 12 feet in an average person that it travels out and can be measured. So that's really neat. The brain, on the other hand, is more like six to eight feet. So the heart, we actually, healthy people, meet each other with their heart fields before we meet with our brain fields. We're meeting each other with the heart. And some people's fields are huge, you know, 30, 40, 50 feet of this strength. And so this particular mantra, it's also called the Mangala Charan Mantra, helps to strengthen our field, but especially strengthen that heart field. So our love and our compassion can expand out to others. So we can help others without actually leaving the house. Isn't that great? You just expand your field. So there's four parts. The first part is Ad Gure Name. And the R's, you try and roll them if you can. The tip of the tongue on the roof of your mouth. Ad Gure Name. And then Jugad Gure Name. Sat Gure Name. Siri Guru Deve Name. So it goes, Ad Gure Name, Jugad Gure Name, Sat Gure Name, Siri Gure De Ve Name. There you go. So the first one, Ad Gure Name, means when you translate it from Sanskrit, I bow to the primal wisdom. And bowing is different than what we think here. It's not bowing down exactly like being subservient. What it means is we're letting the primordial wisdom travel through us and run our show rather than our unhealthy ego. So we're letting the divine run the show, not our unhealthy ego. It's good to have a good sense of self, like a healthy ego, but they're talking about letting go of the unhealthy ego. And then Jugad Gure Name means I bow to the wisdom through the ages. So I'm allowing our ancestral wisdom, the wisdom of the universe again, to guide me. And then Sat Gure Name means I bow to the true wisdom, so truth, the universal eternal truth. And then Siri Gure Deve Name, I bow to the great unseen wisdom. So when we're allowing ourselves to drop down, like in the vagal breathing or in meditation or when we're in nature, and we let our regular busy mind relax, so it's not really thinking, it's just relaxed and aware, then we are tapped in, we're already tapped in, but we're aware that we're tapped in to this unseen wisdom. There's unseen wisdom that's guiding us all the time. And when we're relaxed, we can intuit that. We can hear it or feel it or see it. People interpret it in different ways, but it's always present. But it comes in very subtle whisper. So when we're subtle, we can hear that whisper. So that's what the last verse means. So our arm position starts with hands together at the heart. And then we extend the arms straight up, so it's not straight forward, but up, so about a 45 degree angle. And the diagonals are kind of magical in energy, and it's going to expand our field. Now, internally, if you want to take the next step up, we're visualizing that the arms go up and forward to protect us in the front. And then you can visualize to the side, and then visualize to the back, and visualize to the other side. And that's probably a really good way to begin, because there's a few components here, right? We have the mantra, the arm movement, and then internally visualizing. And what we're visualizing is golden light, like rays of light, forward, side, back, and side. And then it's all coordinated, so that's a bit of a brain exercise. So, Ad Gure Name, the arms extend straight out. And then, Jugad Gure Name, the arms come back in. Sat Gure Name, the arms go back out. Siri Gure Deve Name, the arms come back in. Ad Gure Name, we're projecting straight out. Jugad Gure Name, we're going to the side. Sat Gure Name, we're going behind us. And Siri Gure Deve Name, we're going to the other side. So it's like protecting us in the four directions. And I know I said we do the rays, but that's a little bit more complicated. So we'll start with the foundational practice today. So when you're ready to begin, close your eyes. And you're focusing that you are golden light, and we're going to expand this golden light. So first we're extending in front. Ad Gure Name. And then the hands come in. Jugad Gure Name. Extend to your side. Sat Gure Name, Siri Gure Deve Name. So Ad Gure Name to the front. Sat Gure Name. Let me start again. Ad Gure Name to the front. Jugad Gure Name to the side. Sat Gure Name to the back. Siri Gure Deve Name to the other side. Okay, here we go. We're going to get it this time. Ad Gure Name. Jugad Gure Name. Sat Gure Name, Siri Gure Deve Name, Ad Gure Name, Jugad Gure Name, Sat Gure Name, Siri Gure Deve Name, Ad Gure Name, Jugad Gure Name, Sat Gure Name, Siri Gure Deve Name, Ad Gure Name, Jugad Gure Name, Sat Gure Name, Siri Gure Deve Name. Adgure name, jugadgure name, satgure name, sirgurdeve 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 name. Now inhale deeply, extend your arms straight forward. Hold the breath. Visualize golden light all the way around you, expanding in all directions like a golden sphere. Gently exhale your breath and let your hands return to your heart. Now keep the visualization, breathe naturally. We're going to extend this golden light through our whole home, this light of protection. Protecting everyone and everything. Extending it into our neighborhood, golden light of protection. Over our entire city, our province, our country. Over the entire continent, golden light. And then around the entire world. Beautiful golden light of protection. And then internally chant the mantra all the way around the earth, sending it all the way around the earth. Ad gurei name, jugad gurei name, sat gurei name, siri gurdei ve name. Repeat it over and over. Visualize everyone smiling. Smile back at them. Now bring your awareness to your own heart, the golden light in your heart. And adjust your electromagnetic field. It's a sphere all the way around you. Adjust it to the size that you would like today. So sometimes we want to feel really expanded, and sometimes we want to actually be in a cocoon. And sometimes it's somewhere in between. So just adjust, visually adjust your electromagnetic field. Just see the size that you want to be today. In this moment. Might change later. Being aware of your own electromagnetic field all the way around you. It's like a torus, if you happen to know what a torus is in sacred geometry. And be aware of the golden light in your eyes as you gently open your eyes. You can chant this mantra anytime during the day. It helps to strengthen you and strengthen your field and strengthening protection for yourself and others. Thank you for sharing your practice. Hope you have a very beautiful day. Namaste.